Kazimierz Dabrowski, a Polish psychologist, psychiatrist, and physician, had always been described by his colleagues and followers as being a very unique individual. He had a tremendous energy about him, an animation, a twinkle in his eye, and yet he also had a particular sense of calm. Dabrowski was known for his depth of compassion and his ability to look you in the eye and deeply connect with you. He was born September 1st, 1902, in Lublin, Poland. One of the most significant early influences on Dabrowski was his first-hand experience with World War I. He spoke of being particularly affected by observing the aftermath of a major battle that occurred near his hometown. As Dabrowski walked among the dead soldiers laying in the former playing field, he related how he was fascinated by the various positions their bodies took, and the different expressions frozen on their faces. Some seemed calm and peaceful, while others appeared horrified and frightened. Initially in 1926, Dabrowski entered the University of Warsaw to study medicine and was later given a grant by the Polish National Cultural Foundation to study psychology and education in Geneva, where his instructors included Edouard Clapardy and Jean Piaget. Upon completing his doctoral degree in psychology, he studied at Harvard and returned to Poland in 1934, where he embarked on a prolific writing career, which would include works on behaviorism, self-manipulation, and nervousness in children. In 1937, the first signs of his personality research could be clearly seen. Little is known of Dabrowski's life during the Second World War in occupied Poland. He was known, however, for his cooperation with the Polish underground in providing hiding places for soldiers of Poland's National Army. Post-war statistics have shown that of the 400 psychiatrists that practiced before the war, only 38 survived. After the war, he returned to Warsaw, where he founded a high school of mental health, which expanded rapidly to include 12 branches and 20 dispensaries in 1948. In the 1960s, Dabrowski traveled extensively to the United States, France, and Canada, working in hospitals and writing journals, and piecing together what would later become his major work, The Theory of Positive Integration. Though his theory is not well known today, at the time, Dabrowski's writing was unique in his approach to personality development. He saw personality as the dismantling of the initial character structure during the course of one's life, and consciously replacing it in order to form your personality. This theory focused on defining and measuring a person's developmental potential by taking into account three main groups of factors. The first factor, genetic and permanent physical traits. The second factor, influences of the social environment. And the third factor, conscious self-transformation. Dabrowski asserted that a person's developmental potential, and therefore their realization of personality ideal, can be limited to one factor, encompassed in two factors, or be the result of all three. Dabrowski's theory can be summarized best in his own words. Disintegration means the differentiation through loosening of structures, the dispersion and breaking up of psychic forces. The term disintegration is used to refer to a broad range of processes, from emotional disharmony to the complete fragmentation of the personality structure. Loosening and even fragmenting the internal psychic environment and conflicts with the internal environment and the external environment are the grounds for birth and development of higher psychic structures. Disintegration is the basis for developmental thrusts upward, the creation of new evolutionary dynamic, and the movement of the personality to a higher level.